Did you know the country radio banned at least 8 of Loretta Lynn's songs? Hard to believe, right? Now, Loretta Lynn is known as the Queen of Country Music, and her career spanned 62 years. You know, she came from small-town Butcher Hollow, Kentucky, and she was the daughter of a coal miner. She married Doolittle Lynn when she was just 13 years old, and she had 6 children. Now, her marriage with Doolittle was not always easy because he was an alcoholic and he cheated on her quite a lot. But Loretta once said that one of the reasons that she stayed with him was that he thought I was something special, more special than anyone else in the world, and never let me forget it. That belief would be hard to shove out the door. I can understand that. And Doolittle actually bought Loretta her very first guitar. She taught herself how to play and then started writing songs. Loretta grew in her talent and career, and in 1967, she started finding her success. In Lynn's 90-year life, she wrote hundreds of songs. Many of those she recorded for release, and 16 went to number one. Loretta wrote about what she knew, raw, real-life issues that were faced by women, including infidelity, divorce, and contraception. And that's what started getting her into trouble, as well as propelling her to success. While women identified with Loretta's songs, country radio had some problems with them. At least 8 of her songs were banned from radio airplay, but they became hits anyway. In a 2021 interview with Parade magazine, Loretta said, "Risk taker? No. I just write what I feel, what is going on with me and my life. It just happened that a lot of other women felt the same. I would never set out to write something just for it to shock someone. I am not that clever. It's always been about truth, and if that means radio wants to ban it, well, that's their problem. Most of my records they banned became number one anyway." Her first banned song was "Don't Come Home a Drinkin' with Lovin on Your Mind" in 1966. It went to number one.
A liquor and love, they just don't mix, leave the ball or me behind. And don't come home but drinkin' with lovin' on your mind.
Her other banned songs include "Wings Upon Your Horns" in 1969, which is about a young woman who loses her virginity to a man who then leaves her. 1968's Fifth City was a warning to another woman to stay away from her man.
If you don't want to go to Fifth City,
interestingly, Chapel Heart did an update to this song called "Welcome to Fifth City." Now, Chapel Heart took the world by storm with their song "You Can Have Him, Jolene," which was an update to Dolly Parton's famous hit, "Jolene." Apparently, Loretta loved the song and asked the ladies of Chapel Heart when they were going to update one of her songs. And so they did with "Welcome to Fifth City."
Been your nose around another woman's home has earned you a trip to Fifth City. So welcome to Fifth City. There's some rules we gotta lay down.
Let's get back to Loretta's banned songs. In 1972, Rated X addressed how divorced women were looked upon back in the 70s. They were looked down on by other women and treated like objects by men. One of the lines in the song says, "The women all look at you like you're bad, the men all hope you are." Now, one of the biggest controversial songs of Loretta's career was 1975's "The Pill," which was banned by 60 radio stations. And according to People magazine, a preacher in Kentucky preached against the song. But apparently all of this just spurred people to go buy the record. The song made it to number 5 on the U.S. charts, and once again, People magazine reported it was selling 15,000 copies per week, even without airplay. Now, the song has humorous lyrics, but some people did not like the content.
Mini skirts, hot pants, and a few little fancy frills. Yeah, since I've got the pill.
According to Lynn, it's just a wife arguing with her husband. The wife is saying, you've kept me barefoot and pregnant all these years while you've been slipping around. Now you straighten out, or I'll start now that I have the pill. It's a husband and wife, not two unmarried people. So that's not dirty, she added. Now, there was also a chance that the Opry might ban her from performing the song on the show. And she made it pretty clear that if they tried to ban her from performing that song, she would quit the Opry if they did. In a 1987 interview with the San Diego Union, she noted country stations banned 8 of her songs, but she felt it was a good sign. As soon as I heard one of my songs got banned, she said, I knew it would go to the top of the charts. So banning Loretta's songs from radio might not have hurt her bottom line, but she had a theory for why it happened. I was saying things girls weren't supposed to say, but I didn't realize they weren't supposed to. Because I got married at 13 and had kids, I hadn't been out in the world and hadn't realized I'd upset people. So Loretta was banned for just writing and singing about things in everyday life. She wasn't trying to start a revolution, but she certainly got people's attention. All right, well, I hope you like this video. If you're enjoying my content, I would love it if you would subscribe to my channel. Helps me out. I would really appreciate it. And drop me a line in the comments. Let me know what you thought about the video. What did you think about Loretta's songs being banned? You know, it was a different time, right? Different things were banned. Nowadays, when we hear songs on the radio, it's stuff that would make those people back from the 60s and 70s really blush, right? So definitely drop me a line. Do you remember listening to any of these songs and wondering, you know, why aren't they being played on the radio? So leave me a comment. Let me know. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.